And welcome back to Flexible Games, where we are playing FortressCraft Evolved, Frozen Factory. Well, now that we have missiles, we're getting a good supply of them, and it looks like our wires are keeping up. Looks like our pipes are keeping up, though we are draining a little bit. Looks like our fuel is keeping up. And they've been going full blast now for a while, and it's looking pretty good. So we have to go to two more systems. First, I want to kick off starting the research on the next big missile systems that we're going to need. And this is the missile defense. And I should have all of the pods ready to go. I might need to add a few bars here and there. But see, our attack is imminent, so I can go ahead and kick this off. And let's see if I can find my lab somewhere in that little mess over there. Oh, I think that's it right there. And missile defense and start it. Go over and check the pods. I might be short a pod or two. Just because of reasons. Yeah, I think. I don't know. Maybe not. We'll see. It's maybe a single pod. I can look at the. Yeah, right here. Is titanium plate. So I might be short an ultimate. I might not, I don't know. Okay. Now we need to go to a launch system. Because we want to deploy these missiles, and I've got a little hole dug over there for a reason. I wanted to place this in a spot that wasn't directly on a diagonal to my CPH, so the system didn't block anything at all. And I want to go up. I'm not going to go up like 64. I've been doing that, and that's a little too high. Because I mine out the corners, they're usually pretty low as far as, you know, their angle of coming in. So I don't want to go too high. So I'm going to go like, let's see what the vantage point is up here. It looks, let me get rid of my fog for a little bit. F10, by the way, does that. So yeah, up here is a pretty good vantage point. I think this is good enough. We're going to then set up a system once I get a platform built. I want to make sure that it is good to go. So we're going to come out a ways from each side of this, forwards and backwards. And I've got a new design that I'm going to try out. It's not always a good thing to do that without testing it first, but, you know, why not? It's going to be kind of haphazard as I build it here. Just stick with me. Okay, and then the very center. Oh, I want to come out maybe two more on this side. I can always take blocks away, but when I'm up there working, it's a little harder to see the whole picture. I want to take this very center block out. Okay. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to put a regular hopper. How do I want to do this? I want to put a regular hopper right here. And then I'm going to get really fancy. And I'm going to use a matter mover to go up. I don't want anything blocking that path. So the matter mover will beam the missiles up to the top. It'll beam them right up to here. So I shouldn't have moved that. I'm going to put another half storage hopper here. Maybe I want to put that up one. I'm going to go up one more. You'll see in a second why. Okay, let's go down and grab that. Okay, now we just need to bring most of these missiles over. But one of the things I want to do is I want to consolidate them into some hoppers first. So these are going to go in like that. Let's go underneath. It's a pretty handy. Oh. Yeah, my base is under attack. I know. We're working on it. Okay, so these are all going to come out. Out. There we go. And then in. All right. Same setup here. I should be able to just do this. Okay, and then one here. Consolidate all these. That way I can look in here and see how many missiles there are. And that way these fill up. Now I need to actually put all the missiles into here. Oh, I forgot I could do super build. Oh well. Okay, so there are those. Now for these I could probably just consolidate all of these into one. That way, what I'm going to do is I'm going to use this hopper to pull out other ones to imbue. I want to imbue some, and I actually want to see what happens with some other fanciness that we can do. And in order to save a little, we're going to stop this for a second. And stop this. There we go. I want to go underneath with these. And we're going to need more conveyor belts. All right, conveyor belts. And we're going to go up and over like this for reasons. Because we need power. Our matter transmitter. Because this guy needs to beam right into that thing. Just like that. And it's going to use a lot of power to do so because we're going to be using a lot of missiles. And now I've got some more materials to work with. I want to make, how many of these do I want? Let's see. Missile turrets, servo motors. Okay, let's see.
I want at least 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
I want at least like to start. Like let's build more than I think I need. And then to get back up here, we're gonna take this one out. Because I have induction chargers. I made a couple more of these, if I can find them. There they are. Because we're going to have, centered on this block, we're going to have an induction charger. I usually use a lot of batteries and solar panels for all of this. But these induction chargers should be really handy. Is that centered on that? It is. Just, they don't appear right away, and that's really confusing. There we go. Now you see why I had wanted to elevate that a little bit. Because we're going to push into here. So where are my missiles at? Okay, let's get our missiles going. Let's see. We want... I know they're in here. I got so much crap in my inventory. I really got to clean this. Really got a clean house here. Let's see. Missile turrets. I know I built a few of them. There they are right in front of my face. So I want 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And then to put the missiles in, we're going to put a hopper right in between them all. Okay, that one appeared. And then I want a half storage hopper. That beams or pushes them all in like that. And then I've got solar panels for the corners. I actually don't know how many I need here. I'm going to put one there and one there. And that is getting some power. And now I just need to push the missiles into there. And there we go. Now do the same thing to the other side. Kind of confusing when nothing is actually showing up. I know you're there. That's funny. Update. Alright, we have missiles. I just lost the attack, so nothing is going to fire, unfortunately. And that's about as much as I can do. I could, if I was a smarter person, I could put a battery on the outside here. And then another missile turret. This This should be charging. There is the charge. So I could go to each side of this and add another missile turret. I think that was all that I built, though. Yep. I should be able to see from here. Build one more. And now I can do the front as well. So I need two more. Yeah, two more. One there with a missile turret. And one right there with another missile turret. There, that is, how many is that? 3, 6, 9, that's 18 missile turrets. And these are still not updating, which sucks, but they are there. You can see they're highlighting, they are there. So these should have plenty of firepower to launch. Now, as far as introducing better missiles, what I can do once that research is done is augment our missiles and then push them right back into the system. So that is, when you want to imbue a missile, you're going to want at least one turbine per imbuer if you're going to have a prayer to eke all those out. So these are down to the last 70, and it's pushing pretty hard. Let's make sure we have enough. So we need 34 and 33. 33 and 33. Yeah, we're going to have enough. Okay, good. Once we get missiles up and running, especially like the imbued, and I really kind of am curious about the cluster missiles. Once we get those up and running, we're going to go full on to the OET. And once we charge the OET and discharge it and kill at least three of the corners, that's when I start in on the frozen factory stuff. I like to have a good defense system set up because if your CPH goes down, your frozen factory machine goes down and everything else kind of goes down with it. So we got to be careful about that. And we're going to need a lot more material. What is that floating? Anyway, so we're gonna need a lot more material. These special machine blocks I've been building, we're gonna need a lot of those, plus some new ones that the frozen factory introduces with all the new ores that we're gonna use. So these are all done, and I'm gonna collect all of these first. All of these. These are all tubes. This is where I get all my tubes at. So I want those to fill up again. I want a lot of those. And then all of these. This is also tubes. I'm not really using clocks at the moment. I'm not making anything with them. Let's go see how our overclocker has been faring over here. It looks like, yeah, it is done with 200 of those. Not bad. So let's put another 200 in. Go for broke on that, and I'm going to just gather a bunch of the crystal clocks that are over here. That'll use the crystal that's in here, and that's fine. Okay, we have a good setup now for defense. The other thing I'm going to need are beacons over here. I don't have any beacons to speak of. Oh. Let's see. I don't have any beacons to speak of over here. So instead of using the blue, I'm going to try to use my Mark III's over here. As you can see, there are no beacons. I cleared it, but I didn't put any beacons around here. So we're going to do that. And we're just going to kind of walk a little ways. Put another one. Walk a little ways. I'm not sure what the range is on these, but it's not an exact science for me. Let me grab that. And walk a little ways. Do it again. One more time, because I have one more organic solar panel left. Yeah, the last attack came from this corner, and it was just packed full of bug parts. So I want to make sure I'm collecting those as best as I can. Looks like the shadows on my world are kind of going a little crazy. Oh, it looks like it picked up some stuff. Coal ore? No. There, now we've got some bug part collection over here, which is all right and good. I need some right in here. I've got one right there, but it's not, doesn't really cut it. A lot of them collect right up in this area here. So I'm going to need another set, probably right in here. I have the battery, I just don't have the solar power. I'm a little low on the heavy and light chitons to be able to build more solar power or organic solar panels. See if I have any more over here. Oh, this is a new problem. Oh, my loads aren't very high. 2,900 conveyors, 5,300 machines. Actually, it's not bad at all. I don't know why. What is causing that? But we'll have to end the episode here. So I thank you for watching, and I will see you next time.